Hey YouTube fam, it's your girl Gladys, aka Is That Your Hair? And welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, make sure you tap that subscribe button before you go. Hit the notification bell so that you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. And if you've been rocking with me for a minute, what's up, what's good, and welcome back. So y'all saw the title of today's video. Today we are talking about how to make your wig look as natural as possible. Featuring Nisha 206. If you're unfamiliar with Nisha, this is a textured wig by Outre. The original Nisha came out years ago. However, Outre revamped these Nishas and they called it Outre Nisha Soft and Natural. This line definitely took the wig community by storm. I've literally reviewed all the Nishas at this point. So if you want to check those videos out after this video, I will leave my Nisha playlist in my description box. Me personally, I love the Nisha series because it just caters to my favorite texture, which is textures that mimic my natural type 4 hair, blown out straight. So today we have Nisha 206, which is their newest from the line, and it's a bob kind of style with these nice little layers here. On the stock card, it is shown as the middle part, but today I'm gonna be rocking her to the side because I saw my girl Brittany, AKA the Hearts and Cake 90. I loved her view on this new Nisha bob and I liked how she did hers to the side. And we normally have the same taste, so I know I'm gonna just rock this joint to the side. I really hope this video helps someone, y'all, because I know how it is when you first start with wigs, you just don't really know what to do. I have always liked plain hair, but some people are just not naturally gifted when it comes to hair. And they need the extra help. They need the tutorials. So I'm hoping that this video will be a great beginner's guide for people who are either brand new to wigs or they just need some extra assistance with making theirs look natural. So this video is gonna be very detailed. I'm gonna be going through what I would do to make this wig look natural. I'm going step by step. I have done videos like this in the past featuring Janet Collection Jode and featuring Outre Nisha 204. So if you wanna check those out, feel free because I give a lot of great tips on how to make my wigs look natural. This video is just more of an updated tutorial. So if you're ready to see how to make your wigs look natural in 2020 and beyond, keep on watching. All right, so we have Nisha 206 here in the 1B color. And the reason why I wanted to use this unit is because it just came out, so I know people are checking for her. But on top of that, I think when it comes to a wig looking natural, like when it comes to people saying like, girl, is that your hair? If the wig mimics my hair, it makes it even more believable. So that's why I wanted to use a textured unit. And I also think the shorter styles often look very realistic on me. Not saying that it can't look real if it was longer. I mean, lots of people have long natural hair. I just know for me, my natural hair stops like around here. So this is mimicking close to my particular hair. So when I'm looking at a wig, I like to look at the construction, and you'll see here that Nisha has the two combs here in the front, a comb in the back with adjustable straps. And you'll notice the lace color. The lace color is light. And that's something to keep in mind if you plan on wearing this wig to the hairline. So I'm just gonna toss this wig on. I'm gonna tell you my thoughts with her straight out the pack. So as soon as I toss her on, I'm like, wow, the style is pretty, it's cute. I already know I'm not really in the mood to have her in the middle. I mean, it's cute, but the side is where it's at for this wig. So I'm gonna tilt her to the side. Now, when you're putting on wigs, you have to think about what exactly makes a wig look natural. Think about it from your point of view when you're looking at other people who wear wigs. What about it makes it look natural? And I think for me, a lot of it has to do with how the wig lays on your head first and foremost. When you throw this wig on, you're not going out the house like this. Like this is not natural because it's humpy up here. Right? And the lace is showing. So you know you have to address those two areas. You have to address how the wig is laying on your head, and you have to address the lace and making this parting space look natural. A lot of times when I see people wearing wigs, usually the dead giveaway that their wig doesn't look natural is the parting space. A lot of people have issues with making their parting space look natural, so I'm hoping this little section right here will help y'all out. Now, the first thing you need to keep in mind when wearing wigs, very first thing that's important with making your wig look natural is having a flat foundation. Right now, my braids are a little bit old, so it's not the flattest it could be, but I urge you, if you are wearing your wigs, please make your foundation flat. Whether you do cornrows like I normally do, or some people have their hair slicked back very, very straight and they're able to make their wigs work. I prefer cornrows because I'm just not good at slicking my natural hair back well enough to go under some of these wigs. Like, for natural hair wigs, it's cool, but for the sleeker ones, it just takes a lot of work. I'd rather just get it braided. So please make sure your foundation is on point, first and foremost. The next thing you have to look at is how the wig is laying on your head and the parting space. So we're gonna start here. I'm gonna first adjust the wig to where I want it to be. This is where I want the wig to be. Now, I noticed that this naturally is not coming all up on my hairline. I could pull this up and I can use the combs to make it lay there. But honestly, I don't wanna fool with this light lace right now. I just don't wanna do it. I have tint spray that I like to use on wigs, but this is not like a frontal. Like, this is supposed to be simple and easy. And I'm gonna keep it easy breezy for y'all. So what I like to do is I like to take a black eyeliner of some sort and just fill in all of this and just wear a little bit behind my hairline. Be mindful when you shift your wig to the side, the ear tabs will be here, and that will probably bother some people. So for me, I just cut it off. All right, so I'm gonna go in and literally just fill this in. You guys can use any type of eyeliner. It really doesn't matter. I'm literally just grabbing the eyeliner that was available to me, which is a liquid eyeliner. Normally, I prefer my black crayon. I don't know where the hell it is right now. I will also use a Sharpie. Here's a Sharpie. I use that. You can use that as well. Oh no, this Sharpie's not working.
No, thank you.
This is me using a Sharpie. It does the same damn thing, y'all. It just fills in the lace. If you are the type of person that sells their wigs, I would not use a Sharpie on the lace. I would use something that's actually washable, like eyeliner. I don't want any of that to show. All right, now this is a very important part. We gotta get this parting space together. Right now, I'm just gonna use the comb here and try to just figure out how I want this parting space to go. So I think when it curves, it looks a little bit more natural. If I want this here, I'm going to try to separate some space here. I'm just gonna use some of my Got to Be glue gel in the black bottle to make that parting space more clear. Okay, so now I'm going to put this black Got to Be glue underneath the lace. Let it get tacky. All right, we're on our way. So I applied that Got to Be glue gel here, used the blow dryer for it to get tacky. And now once it's dry, only when it's dry, that is when you apply the pressed powder. You don't wanna apply the pressed powder when the gel is still wet because it'll just look like an ooey gooey mess. So please let it dry before you apply your powder. And I'm going to use my Maybelline Fit Me powder in the 360 color, the mocha color. I like to use this angled brush because I just think this type of angled brush is really great for parting spaces. And this is only $1, y'all, on Amazon. If you want the link to it, check my description box. Love this brush. I have several. So literally, I'm taking my time and coloring in the parting space. This is super important. Please do not skimp on your parting space. You have to take the time to make this look natural, y'all, because this is where I see people mess up. Y'all be messing this up. Don't want to take the time to address your parting space, and then you're wondering why your hair looks wiggy, okay? And you'll notice that this is also changing the color of the lace so that it looks more brown. I'm doing this in natural lighting because I want you all to see exactly what it's going to look like when I walk out my house. Be careful with this part because it's easy to apply too much powder. Like, this right here is a little too much, so I'm probably going to like press at it and dab at it. You know what I'm saying? I don't want this to look too much. And sometimes what I'll do is I will also go in with a darker powder to offset the powder color if I feel like it's too bright. And this is just a powder I got from the beauty supply store, but there's a link to it in my description box on Amazon. It's by Ruby Kisses, and it's really like a brown powder. But sometimes I like to put this on top to help blend. Now looking at the parting space, look at that. That looks much better than what it was looking like a few minutes ago. I'm just combing this here so that the hair gets out the way. This looks much better. It's actually looking like scalp. Wow. This is how you make your parting look natural, y'all. I'm going in with the darker powder over here towards the front because my skin is dark. I'm still pressing down on this here because it wasn't completely dry, so. But I'm pressing down a little bit and you can see that it is blending in well. Now, as I'm doing this, what I like to do to make sure that it is blending properly is I will tilt my head up in the natural light to see if I see a line of demarcation. I don't see a line of demarcation, but it, to me, it's looking a little bit crusty. So I'm just going to try to take this brush and brush away at it a little bit. I'm doing an extreme close-up for you all so you can see exactly what this process is looking like. I feel like this is looking pretty darn good, if I do say so myself. Now, if you want to kind of go in and brighten up the space a little bit, you can. It's not totally necessary. But you can. Yeah, that looks good, y'all. Come on, is that... Who gonna check me, though? This is my hair! What? This is my hair! Oh, wait, I gotta cut this out. Hold on, I'm about to just use this and cut this out. Literally, I just sliced it off. Sliced that off because that's just getting in the way. There's gonna be some shedding when you do that, so just take those shedded hairs out. And then look at that. This is already looking so much more natural. Now, I did notice with this wig that they have like some filler hairs right here. I don't know why the hell they would do that, because I don't think this is the type of style that calls for filler hairs at all. But I feel them. It feels a little like crinkly curlies at the root. I don't know like why they did that. I am now gonna take my blow dryer and press it against my roots here so that way it lays a little bit flatter. All right, and the last thing I'll do is just make this even. I'm going to just snip a little bit from the bottom here. Those of you who know me know that I'm no stranger to the scissors. So yeah, snip, snip. And yeah, we are pretty much done here. What do you all think? We're not serving hairline here, but at least if the wind blows, you're not gonna be seeing like white ashy lace. So that's a good thing. And if you are the type of person who likes to lay their edges, you know, just make sure you lay your edges before you go out the house. But I think this is looking much more natural now. Let's do a little comparison shot. You see, this is looking much better. So overall, when it comes to making your wigs look natural, please remember these points. Foundation must be flat if you have hair along your hairline, and if you notice that it's either not fitting properly on your head, or if for some reason your braids underneath are a little bit older, definitely consider wearing your wig a little bit behind the hairline and then just filling it in with some type of black Sharpie marker or a black liner. And most importantly, pay attention to your parting space, because that's the difference between people who put in the effort and people who don't. 9 times out of 10, it's usually obvious when people are not putting in the effort to make their wig look natural. Like, I feel like this is looking like fresh press over here. Gladys, you did that. As far as this wig itself, I think she's super cute. Under $30. I love the texture. Not too keen on her in the middle, but I think to the side, she is definitely a look. And she's fitting on me, I would say, probably medium head front. Please let me know how you feel about this video in the comments down below. Was this video helpful to you? Did you learn something from this video that you didn't know before? Talk to me in the comments, because I love to talk to all of you. Also, if you want to see me more textured wigs, check out my textured wig playlist. I have a slew of wigs that are similar to this, kinky curly, kinky straight, that I love to rock, and I would love for you all to see. And if you are new here and have not subscribed yet, tap that subscribe button, hit the notification bell so that you don't miss anything coming up. Shout out to Sam's Beauty for sending me this lovely chic bob. I love me a good bob. Ah, she's cute, y'all. She's cute. I look like I just came out the salon. I also have a Bob playlist. Check that out in the description box as well. And if you want to see some of my latest videos, check them out over here to the right of me. Thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.